संद्रू संद्रू, am I audible?
यस सर, रेडी सर।
यस यस चंद्रू, यू विल प्रोसीड विद यूट्यूब लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग।
डन सर।
ओके थैंक यू। मैडम पंकज बल्ली।
यस सर।
मैडम, ओनली द फैकल्टी मेंबर्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस बीसी एंड सीटीआईटी विल बी जॉइनिंग थ्रू ज़ूम, एंड द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द थ्री डिपार्टमेंट्स विल बी जॉइनिंग थ्रू यूट्यूब लिंक।
ओके सर। ओके,
आई शैल बी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम, इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 10:29।
Okay, okay, I'm ready at my end.
Madam Renuga, proceed please. Thank you.
A warm good morning to all. Coupled with cool soothing effect, our happiness knows no bounds to welcome you all to this great feat, interdisciplinary program Diksharam, student induction program on introduction and importance of subjects or courses of study, organized by the departments of computer science, computer technology and information technology, and computer applications, sponsored by the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, under the DBT Star College scheme. A dream does not become reality through magic. It takes rest, determination, and hard work. To set up this propitious occasion, I would like to call upon Ms. S. Vidya, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Department of Computer Science, to welcome the gathering.
Hari Om, respected president of today's function, our honorable respondent, Timothy Palanisamy Avargal, respected principal, Dr. N. Raman, distinguished chief guest of this induction program, Dr. P.B. Pankajwali ma'am, and the faculty members of our institution and home department, a warm good morning to all of you. It gives me a great pleasure to welcome all of you to the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, under DPT Star College scheme sponsored interdisciplinary program conducted by UG Department of Computer Science in association with Department of Information Technology and Computer Technology, Department of Computer Application, Kongo Arts and Science College, Erode. Ours is the institution which stands always first and assuring the best in fulfilling the students' need. The motivation of our correspondent drives this mega event happen. He is a person with great vision, practical ideas, and valuable suggestions. He is always a moral supporter of activities we are carrying out for the benefit of student community. With much delight and gratitude, I welcome our correspondent. Our principal, Dr. N. Raman, has always been an inspiring personality behind all our initiatives associated with each and every activity of our department. We welcome you, sir, on this auspicious occasion. With immense happiness and honor, we welcome the reserved person, Dr. P.B. Pankajwali, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, School of Computer Science and Engineering, Vardhya University, Kanpur. We welcome you, ma'am. I gladly welcome the DPT Department Coordinator and Head of the Department, Mr. P. Ramesh, who have offered his effort in making this event happen successfully. I welcome you, sir. I would like to welcome my fellow colleagues, all heads and faculty members from various departments. Your presence here highly motivates us. My special welcome goes to the press and media persons, to the students' induction program, who are here to take this function to the public. Once again, I welcome you all for this interdisciplinary program. Have a pleasant day with Kongo family. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. The secret of getting ahead is getting started. Now it's time to introduce our eminent resource person of today's program. Now I invite Ms. P. Kritika, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Department of Computer Applications, to present the bio sketch of our resource person.
Good morning, all. I am professionally happy to introduce our chief guest, Dr. P. B. Pankajwali ma'am, who has done doctoral degree in computer science with 18 years of teaching experience in various institutes. At present, she is working as assistant professor in Department of Computer Science, School of Computer Science and Engineering, Vardhya University, Coimbatore. She has completed a funded project with a grant of 25 lakhs from the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. Also, by being a principal investigator and co-investigator, she is going on with two other funded projects, worth 25 lakhs and 39 lakhs, from BSG and RUSC, MHRD, Government of India, Secretary. She also filed an Indian patent for her project based on wireless networking. She has published more than 100 research papers and presented several papers in national and international conferences. Also, she is a keen reviewer in 4 journals, such as Elsevier with Specialization to Energy, Elsevier Gene, Elsevier Gene Reports, Advance in Information Science, and Service Science Journal. She has authored some book chapters by being associated with IGI Global VSV. She has received the Best Teacher Award from Lions Club and also been awarded as an outstanding woman in the field of science from various international journals. Her areas of interest include ad hoc network, wireless sensor networks, and Internet of Things. She has received the Governor Award during January 2013 for her best service in organizing ST John Ambulance First Aid Training Program in Kong Arts and Science College. Apart from teaching, she actively involves in various professional activities. We are honored by your presence, ma'am. Now the session is yours.
Thank you, ma'am, for your introduction. I thank the team Kongu, the honor, the correspondent, the principal, who have been behind you all to take up this event. And it's not easy to get a DBT staff team. So applause from my end to you all for the rigorous effort what you might have taken to get this thing. And good morning to one and all again. And I hope I can go into my session. Right? Is there any other formality?
Please proceed, ma'am.
Okay. Hope my screen is visible at your end.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, full ma'am. Screen, please.
Full screen? Is it visible or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, fine. My voice is it audible?
Yes, please.
Ma'am. Yes, okay. So again, my special good morning to all the students who are here, who's eager to get inside the college, but still due to this COVID situation, sitting at your home, at your devices. A warm welcome to you all to Team Kongu or the Kongu family. We always quote it as Kongu family. Still, I feel that I'm part of it. So that is why whenever an occasion happens, the Team Kongu never fails to call me or invite me on some way or other. I'll be part of the team. Though I'm being an external member presenting here, I feel that I'm one among your team where I'm into part of coordination. So thanks for remembering me always. The topic, what it is given to me, it's not the choice of my topic. It's what the need of first year where you should be aware of it. So the introduction and importance of subject or course of study. So throughout my talk, I indicate that it's computer science. It doesn't mean that I'm maintaining or quoting only the Department of Computer Science. It's a very discipline like CT, IT, and BC. I quote everyone in a single term called computer science. That is a field of computer science. And the importance or introduction, it's like the first slide I would like to... Okay. Congratulate the students who have taken up this course. I assure you, I don't know the situation, what is at your end because of your parents' force you came into this course or out of your willingness or out of your confusion you came into the course. But whatever it may be, now set your mind that you can feel happy and comfort that you have got inside the department of 4 departments, CT, IT, BC or computer science, whatever it may be. So you have a good team of faculty who will guide you in all means to improve, to get a step into your career path. I assure you on that part, and I congratulate the team who made this day, who remember me and who bring out every occasion to be the best. And I welcome you all to my session. And initially, I'm not, throughout my session, I'm not going to talk only about the curriculum. So my talk will be of a few talk things about the curriculum and what subject you're going to go through throughout this 3 years period. The subject and this, I'm not going to deep inside any of the subjects, just I'm going to overlay of the subjects, what it is you're going to come across these 3 years. And then I'll say, when you being a entry into your collegiate education from your school education, the basic things of what I, being a teacher, noticed from the student point of view, I would like to brush up on that part also. It's not that I'm not going to bore you the complete 1 hour session with a full of talking about curriculum. So once you enter the college, once your subject gets started, obviously you'll understand many things. When I say deep into it, you'll not get it. So I'm giving an overview of what, how the curriculum has been framed and what it will give you, how you have to take up it, and how to go, and a pathway can be taken from this session. Initially, this is how your evolution of computer system was there. It started like you could see in this screen, a big room full of some rack full of some components like chips and processors are there. The earlier stage, this is called as a computer. What they do is they just trigger the components in order to generate, to get loaded. So once we put on a machine, within a fraction of seconds, we could see our machine gets loaded. And if the fraction of seconds get varied for a minute, we say that my system has become down. It's not as speed as it was earlier. But in the earlier days, how it was like us, they put on the machine and they go for a walk and have a coffee and they'll come back to get the machine started. That was a scenario at the initial stage where the evolution of computer system started. And then they started with reducing the size of the machine, and where your chips, the microprocessors or the integrated chips started coming in the size, reduction in size till miniature size now, what we are using it. So how things went on, went with a desktop, then with a laptop, then with a palm top, and then mobile. And now you could see a person is inbuilt, or it is embedded inside a body for a few functionings of our body. So it's like a mechanical movement. What we humans, we need certain energy to work on. So the machines inside us is incorporated in order to make your body system to function properly. In healthcare, many have been incorporated. Even they incorporate a sensors in their hand to measure the diabetic patients. I could see one of my friend who has incorporated a sensor to measure the diabetic's level, what calories he takes, what carbohydrates he takes, how much level it is. When it goes beyond, it automatically gives an indication, and he was beyond the limit of the level of diabetic content, and now he's in normal. So that is how the machines are, evolution of technology is keeping on growing. So being a computer science student, it's very difficult for us to update with all this technology and get thorough on everything. But keeping pace with the recent technologies and the topmost, which is leading, is our, though it is in curriculum or not, it's our duty to learn about things where we pass day to day. And hope you could see the two laptops. This was the first laptop which was introduced in 1981, the concept of mobile computing. So where they tried to bring out a laptop in mobility. So usually we'll have a desktop machines sitting at one end. So they thought, why don't we carry the machine wherever we go? And that came out with an idea of a laptop. So this laptop, you could see the screen size, even now our mobile screens are bigger than this. This was a screen initially in the first laptop, and you could see the keyboard, and your speakers will be here, and all the ports, USB port or HDMI, whatever port it is, everything will be here. And it's a heavy machine where you have to carry it heavily, but they try to achieve something like a mobile machine. The mobility has been achieved in this, Now it is a high-end laptop with a sleek machine with high-end processors. Wherever we go, we can take it with a comfort zone. So this is how our computer system initially has been evolved in terms of hardware. And then what is computer science? So computer science is, when I say, many definitions have been come out with the term called computer science. When you say computers, it is like, we can't say any field. Just think for a while where you could see a place without a computer. It's very difficult to point out any one place now in this modern age. Everywhere, when you go to a small grocery store, you could see a person in a billing system with a computer. When you go for a big research department, it's full of machines. Than equal to the research, the machine plays a major role in carrying out their research. So this is how the things is happening. And that is why what I stress, right from your healthcare sector, from your education, for your entertainment, for your commercial takeover, for your business, wherever it is, it's a place where computer stands there. So it's like that you're coming to the right path of learning something in computer in deep. So everyone knows computer. You ask a old age person, ask a person who's a nearby a grandfather, he knows something about computer. But being a techians now entering into the field of computer science, you should know how things are happening inside the computer. So your curriculum has been framed in such a way that the materials or the content or the subject, what you're going to learn for the next 3 years is how your computer is performing in this way. What are the technologies influencing it? And those things will be, you'll learn into deep, not a deep into something like you'll get a clear idea how things are functioning inside a computer. So that is how your curriculum has been framed. And then coming to the part of curriculum. So what is curriculum? So this is a common term where students will not be aware of it. And once you come into the college, the faculty may say about the term called curriculum or syllabi. Where in school days, we don't call, being a school student, you'll not be aware of it. You'll say about which group I have taken in my plus one and plus two in my higher secondary and what subject it is. That's all. We stop with it. So coming to this part of curriculum, it has come out from the Latin word where it is runaway or the race course. So where you're running away, so you're running towards the goal. What is a goal? So when you complete the 3 years of graduation, either it can be computer science, CT, IT or BCA, whatever course you're going to trying to complete at the end of 3 years, that is called as a course of study. So this 3 years period, you'll be fixed with a goal. So you're mentally, you may have some goals. In the degree, I would like to know, is there anyone who can't follow Tamil? Students?
No, ma'am.
No, everyone are comfortable
with
everyone,
Tamil? Yes, okay. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, thank you. And the thing is, everyone will have a goal set in our minds. So being an undergraduate student, you might have a dream by seeing some IT professionals or by seeing some scientists, you might have a dream. Namlu indha mari varano appadina. So andha mari varaku or goal setting indala, andha unnoda goal, basic goals of computer science students are achieve pandrukku, there will be a setting of goals in your department. So they'll have a vision and mission for your college. And from there, it will be focused, your department vision and mission will be focused towards that. At the same time, every course, every subject in your curriculum will be having an objective. They call it a course objective. We'll have an objective and they'll say that when you start studying this course, you should basically know this. When you end up this course, you'll be aware of this. So that is what is fixed for each and every subject you learn throughout this 3 years. So this is one, this curriculum is like teaching and learning. The teachers will give you a lot of inputs where your learning process will be triggered. And it is like self-learning will be there and your one-way knowledge sharing will be there. All platforms will be there here to learn about this complete 3 years period. And then, as I said, your vision, focus, objective and students' needs, everything will be done. So what is this curriculum? A single curriculum cannot be framed as such. It has, it should take a lot of inputs from different aspects. So what are the aspects considered in order to frame the curriculum, what you're going to undergo? So one is about the education policy. You might recently heard about the new education policy, what the central government is imposing with a lot of norms for school children as well. So the education policy we have to consider, and you have to look for the time constraint. You have a stipulated time for your college, 5 weeks or 6 weeks, 6 days per week you have to work, and your working hours and your study, your class hours is of this limit, 5 hours per day or 6 hours per day. So the time constraints is there, and they look at the pedagogy. Pedagogy is the earlier teaching method, what it has been followed, what can be improvised. We never knew we'll be sitting at this line, and then our communication will happen visually in this way. So it's like teaching classroom in the 2 years, the system has completely changed. So a pedagogy of teaching method, we got adapted because of the technology invention and available resources in your institution, the available faculty, the available library, the available resources, all those things will be considered. And apart from it, in order to frame this curriculum, so curriculum is, again, I'm insisting, it is nothing but collection of subject. We call it as a syllabi too. The collection of subjects all put together, stating the objective for each and every subject towards the requirements of students, towards what the industry expects from the students. Based on that, the things will be happening. So how do they frame this curriculum? You say that for a semester, if you have 6 subjects, who is going to decide about the subject? And what inputs, who is going to frame this should be in this subject? When you say about a subject, it will be a vast number of content will be there. How they are going to cut short and give you the crisp way of a very important thing in your subject. So that is framed via the term called BOS. So BOS is nothing but the Board of Studies. So Board of Studies is nothing but a meeting where the few experts will sit together, and they'll decide about what is the need. Who are those experts? One is the faculty members from your department. Everyone will be there. And apart from it, experts, apart from your institution, like from universities, the senior most professors from education background will be coming. And the industry person who will share about what are the current technology and what are the current requirement of the industry, he'll be part of it. And he or she will be part of it. And then alumni, when you get passed out of 3 years, you will be representing as a part of Board of Studies member, saying that after these 3 years of studies, what inputs you have taken in and what it is lacking, what can be done in order to fill the gap between the industry and what you have learned. So all these inputs will be taken in, and based on the inputs given, so that will be formed as a curriculum, or every subject will be decided. For first semester, let the subjects be like this. Since students are coming from different backgrounds, let them learn about the basics, and then we'll go up with the next level. And when you come for your sixth level, all the recent technologies you'll be learning throughout. So this is how your subject or your curriculum or your course of study is framed throughout in order to get the particular content, what you call as a syllabi, in your hands. So semester beginning la or classroom vandona faculty kekpanga the subject syllabus eduthu vechittingla nu. So go through the syllabus, each and every word of syllabus is framed with rigorous effort by collection of team members to make it such a way that at the end of your course of study you should gain something to carry over your career path. And the system what you're going to take up in your college study or course of study is choice-based credit system. So what is this is, earlier it is like we don't have a choice-based credit system, and you'll be given core subjects, you'll learn it. Here, when you come for your choice-based credit system, so every subject will have a credit for it. So I'll say about the credit later. So you'll have the core papers. Core in the sense, the main papers in computer science. And then you'll have when you say about the core, the paper called core will be mandatory, that you have to learn all the subjects in your syllabus, whichever specified as core. And when you say it is an elective, you'll have for every semester, whenever you have an elective option, you'll have 5 to 6 subjects, and you will not learn all the 6 subjects, you learn one from it. So the elective choice will be, since you're an undergraduate level, the choice will be given by your faculty to a particular sections. But when you come for your post-graduation, elective choices will be a little bit varied. So you'll have set of subjects, not like core, you have to learn everything. It's like one subject you'll choose and you'll start learning on it. And then the grading system, it is like CGPA. We call it as a cumulative grade point average. So this CGPA will be considered with a score of 6.77, 8.80. So anything that like 80%, 6.67 or 60% and 65 and above. So that is a CGPA with a grading system of A, B, A plus. This grading will be there when you come for your this sort of choice-based credit system. So credit is a point given for every subject. And at the end of your course of study, the total number of subjects will have a credit of 144. That is 144 minimum credits will be allocated for you during the course of study. And what is this 148 year? This is for only for a group of students who will take up this, I'll tell you later. So basically that credit for, it's not the case that all subject goes with 4 credit. A few subjects will have a 4 credit and few subjects will have a 3 credit, 2 credit, 1 credit. How do these credits get allocated? So these credits will be allocated based on the hours of teaching. So one subject eduthukitina ivlo hours nu fix panuvanga. Every subject will have a certain hours, and the based on the hour, weekly hours, the credit will be fixed for it. So that is how your credit allocation will be done. So you being the student, no need to worry much about the how it has been allocated, but in your syllabi, it will be clearly stated core elective with this credit, this point. So you can look into it, you can brush up your knowledge stating that I'm not aware of it. So you'll be basically, you'll be aware of those systems. And coming to the term subject, from your school education, you'll be aware of the term called subject. What is subject? You say it is a physics subject, where you say it is in chemistry, it is in computer science, where you have a content, where you have to deliver it till your school education is like, it's like area of knowledge where you're gaining about a particular topic. A topic you called as, and when I said it's an operating system, you say that operating system is a subject where I'm learning in deep in order to gain the knowledge about the operating system. So this is happening at your college or school, whatever it is. Your school, in your school point of view, your subject is something with a limited number of pages, a book. When you finish over your book and when you over your exam, that is over. But when you come for your collegiate education, it is not so. So the operating system, whatever is specified in your syllabi, will be a base foundation, and you'll have lot and lot will be available where the knowledge gaining is left to you. The foundation will be given at your course of study, and then getting deep into that particular subject is out of your interest. Now I'm going to say about how your syllabus has been framed on in your complete course of study for these 3 years. What are all the subjects they have framed and how it will be taken up? Initially in your first year of your collegiate education, a language papers, Tamil and English will be there with you. And then you'll have a supportive papers. The supportive is purely it's of non-technical, which is not related to your computer science subject. It's like environmental studies and value education. So for current generation students, where it is a moral and ethical values is lost. When we are doing our school education, a moral science paper is a must in our schools, where we learn about the moral stories and we get impressed with the stories. And in our day-to-day life, the teachers teach us this is a moral value where you have to carry on. But nowadays, due to the curriculum development or the competition level or the technology growth, the moral values are stepping down. So even though you enter into your college education, so your course of study, apart from your technical sound, they give you a value education in terms of moral and ethical values. For one semester, you'll be going with this. And then at the end of 3 year period, you'll have an extension activity. The choice will be left to you. Either you can choose NSS, NCC, YRC, or science club, or sports, or whichever activity you wish. You can make a choice of any one, and you have to have little participation over it, and where a particular score will be given at end of your third year. And stating about the core, as I said, I'll say about these core subjects later in my slides. The core is one or the main subject in computer science. where you are supposed to learn every subject and you have to put out, come out with semester examination. And coming to part with elective, so elective is one, a choice based. So choice based in the sense, they'll give her 5 to 6 subjects in your curriculum, electives will be there. One you will be taking up. It's not like all the subjects you will take up. One you will take up and you will finish for that particular semester. And you have a skill-based subject, like apart from your computer science, when I ask you, what are your hobbies? What is your interest? Few may say, I'm good in riding. Few may say, I'm good in painting. And few may say that I'm good in driving vehicles. Few may say, I'm good in gaming. And it's all left to our choices. I'm good in putting rangoli. I'm good in cooking. So we have some specialized things. I can't say that I'll be good in everything. It's not possible. It may be possible for extraordinary person. It may be. And here, when it comes with your skill-based, what it happens here is your skills, to brush up your skills, they'll explore you with many. Maximum, it will be of practical papers. In BCA, you'll be having your theory-based paper where your animation lab will be there. If you're good and interesting in animating something or coming out with a small, developing a small video, then it can go for this lab. And case studies and tools, many software testing tools will be there. On many practical-based exposure will be given to you so that you can learn something extra only by a practical exposure, where a lab facility and the corresponding software will be available at your end in the lab and Kongu labs, and you can make use of it to learn something out of your interest. And what is this non-major? Basically, when people ask in a major ni eduthirken abingirappa, we say that I am doing my BSc computer science, or I am doing my BCA, or I am doing my BSc CT. This is my major, we say it. உங்க மேஜர் என்ன? என்னோட மேஜர் கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ். வென் அ ஃபேக்கல்டி இஸ் ஹேவ், வாட் டிசிப்ளின் யூ பிலாங் டு? ஐ பிலாங் டு கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ். வாட் மேஜர் யூ பிலாங் டு? ஐ பிலாங் டு கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ். தென் வாட் யூ கால்ட் இஸ் அ நான் மேஜர். ஸோ அப்பார்ட் ஃப்ரம் கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ், யூ வில் பி கிவன் அ பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் டு லேர்ன் ஆர் டு சூஸ். 2-3 டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்ஸ் வில் பி ஆஃபரிங் யூ அ கோர்ஸ் வேர் யூ கேன் டேக் அப் தட் கோர்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபார் பிஎஸ்சி, ஐ ஜஸ்ட் லைக் ஐ கேதர் சம்திங் அபவுட் பிஎஸ்சி கம்ப்யூட்டர் சயின்ஸ். They have 3 departments. One is about CDF is offering a course. So costume design and fashion will be offering. Whoever is interested in textiles, in designing and fashion, can take up one course from them, and you'll have, they'll teach something general, not into deep, where the common non-majors can understand. They'll give you certain inputs and you'll go up with certain examination system for it. Similar way, the electronics people, physics and electronics, will give you a course stating the foundation of electronics. You'll have a subject, a core subject called Internet of Things, which is a major rising trend in today's market in field of IT. So in order to work with your sensors, you need the knowledge of electronics. So those knowledge can be gained from Department of Physics and Electronics. And Department of Biochemistry will be offering certain courses in terms of health aspects, what today we are lacking in it. So those things, those importance will be given from different departments. The choice will be left to you, where you can choose one non-major subject and you can learn during this course of study. And you'll have a project work. So the project work is not like you'll go to the concern, you'll do the project and come back. It's like it's part of your curriculum. It is one among the subject in your syllabi. In your particular semester, you'll take up this project work, you'll work on it, and you'll gain a 100 marks score. And teachers in your department will be your supervisor. They'll be allocated with few students as a guide. You can approach them, you can get an idea about what you have to do, and you can start developing a project in your lab, and you can come out with a small demo, like a project work, a small task, what like a simple automated systems or something, whatever you wish, you can come out as a project worker. And in the previous slide, I was saying about the credits, 144 is minimum credit during your course of study, and 148 is choices left to you. Who can take up the credits above 144? So that is like the term called advanced learners. Who will be considered as advanced learners? When your after completing your first semester, or a second semester, if your CGPA level is greater than 7.5. So when your CGPA level is above 75%, it means that when you say it is above 75%, it is like it will be considered as an advanced learner. So those advanced learners will be given a choice of choosing additional subjects, additional credit subjects to learn on their own. It's like self-learning. The material and book will be given to you. The library cards will be, extra library cards will be given to you. Teacher guidance will be there. But you learn on your own, you gain the credits, and it will be added in your mark sheets. So that is how. So where your maximum credit can lead to is, it can lead to 148. From 144 minimum, it is like, and 148 is choice is left to you. The choice, whoever have a CGP of above 7.5, if you feel like taking up the another subject to learn more, you can take, and your credits will be increased. Automatically, it will be added to your profile. So I wish every one of you to get a CGP of above 75 and to attain, and let this batch be a surprising batch with a credit of above 144 first taken up. And my wishes for you all. And coming out with the subject stating about Swayam, and we called as a MOOC, that is Massive Open Online Course. What is this Massive Open Online Course of Swayam? This is an online course which is offered by the professors from various universities and from IIT. So those professors on a particular subject, they take online sessions and they upload their videos, and then along with the videos, they have set of assignments. So if you wish to take up the course, you can take up the course additionally. You'll learn about that particular subject by listening to that video and submitting assignments. And this is purely a free courses. At the end, when you write up, when you take up an exam, when you're going to write an exam, you have to pay the examination fee and you have to appear for the exam. Once your exam is over and if you get a pass mark, though, that amount will be refunded. This is how the Swayam and MOOC course goes. And it's not like a semester-wise 6 months course. You have a course for 2 weeks duration. You have a course for 4 weeks duration. And even you have a month duration courses. Choice is left to you. A wide variety of courses will be available from basics to the advanced level. All courses will be there. You can look at the objective of the course and the details of the course will be given, and you can listen to it. And if you wish, you can take up the course. So this is where your college opts and opens it and guides you to take up this course. And any clarification, your teachers are there, will guide you in order to take up this course. And I've said the overall structure of your syllabi. Just next, I'm going to touch you on the part of the basic subjects, what you're going to cover in computer science alone. So you'll go through the subject called operating system and digital fundamentals and architecture. It is like a foundation in computer science. Basically, when I come morning or when you go to your lab, what you do is initially put on your machines. Once your machine starts, we don't say machine starts, we say the machine is getting loaded. Machine is booting. Machine boot out, the load out. So what it happens is your complete hardware, the processor, you're putting on the power socket. Once you put on the switch, you put on your processor on, automatically the power gets enabled and the processor starts triggering. So once your processor starts triggering, what it happens is your data, so it's automatically some processing is happening where a hardware and software starts interacting. Your board, CPU, processor, chips are a hardware. The software which enables you to trigger the hardware, and they start interacting to make the machine to function. So the machine, when it gets booted, when you don't have an OS in your machine, will be aware of, everyone will be aware of, in a machine, in a OS, Windows OS, in a OS, Ubuntu. So we say about Mac OS and Apple Mac. So we say about this. This term is aware, but not only for the computer science students. Everyone will be aware of Windows. Everyone will be aware of Mac. Everyone will be aware of Ubuntu. So what here is, how this is going to happen? எப்படி அது boot ஆயுள்ள என்ன function பண்ணது அப்படிங்கறத, you'll be learning from this operating system, the subject called operating system. Suppose if I'm talking over you at the background, my machine is under, I am executing a program at my another end. So simultaneously, I'm doing many process. So the processor is one which is going to handle all this task. So multitasking is going to happen. So how it is going to handle these tasks? Who will be given priority? When 2-3 processes are queuing up for the process, who takes up the first? Which will be given the priority? So those concepts, being a non-major or non-computer students, will not be aware. They'll be aware Windows is an operating system. That's all. You, the computer science students, will be learning how it gets functioned, how it gets things are happening at inside your OS, and how the processor allocates a process, how the memories are getting utilized. So this is how you learn in the OS. When it comes with the digital fundamental and architecture, it states about the I being a sitting at one end, you sitting at one end, and the Kongu team, your organizers and the faculty are sitting at in the Kongu institution. So we three are end, at three ends, and I speak and it gets framed to your end, and it brings, we are connected by a Zoom platform. All my talk is of analog, where the waveforms is generated. I am not talking in terms of zeros and ones. I am taking 110010150. So what it happens is, it will not recognize the number 4, 5, what I say. It recognizes the number zeros and one. Who will recognize? The machine will recognize. Am I speaking to the machine as zeros and ones in order to transfer your data to you? No. I am speaking in terms of my own language, what I know. What the machine, what the talk or the voice which comes out is an analog form, which is grasped by the machine, and it's passed over its over air, and it comes to your end. When it may goes inside your machine, it is of zeros and one. When you hear in your ears, it is of in your analog to your understandable language. So how these things happen, how your numbers 4 and 5 gets converted into 011 or 101, and these things you learn about the RAM, the memory usage, everything will be in the subject. And when I come across a saying about the logic, or basic logic modeliyan, I'm nariya time nammaloada daily usage la use pandra term. In the logic modeliyan, ni eppadi inda vela seira. So this is what we come across in homes, in a public places. So being a computer science students, when you go for your programming, you should understand basic logic while you're doing your program. It's not like putting in and vomiting. So that should be done at your end. And when you say about mathematics as a foundation in all subjects, excuse me. Mathematics is a foundation in all subjects. So when you say it is in mathematics, what it happens here is, you'll have certain foundation in mathematics. So it's not the pure mathematics syllabi. You'll call it as a discrete mathematics, where the logics and certain grammars, how it is used in your computers, will be taught in this subjects. And then you learn about the software engineering. So whenever a task is given to you at your home, when people come and talk with you, when your mother gives you a task, let us assume you being us to in your home. So your mother is saying, go and get this item from a shop. And your friend is calling over a phone, let us meet here in this ice cream parlor. And at the same time, your sister is calling you and saying that, come and pick me. So three tasks has been given to you. So how do you plan to carry out these tasks? How do you, which is best? Which should be done first? And which should be carried over next? So you're planning, analyzing in order to carry out the simple tasks done at home. The same thing when you come for your work, or when come develop your project, you need a rigorous planning. Before developing a project, we need to analyze what is required, how should we plan it, how should we design it, and how should we evaluate and develop it and deploy it. So all those things will be taught in your software engineering. And optimization techniques, once you enter your college, let us assume a COVID situation, everything has gone, you're freshly entering into your campus, your main gate, you have been entering and you're coming and all the way through, and you're directed to Department of BCA. And people say in the security gate that BCA is near boys hostel. So what is left? You have three paths over there. As I guess, I don't know, the past 2 years I didn't visit the institution. I guess that there are three paths to reach to that particular road of a boys hostel road. So being a new people, you may ask a certain person which is the right route. And when you see your teachers will use the shortest route. And when you see a new student, he'll use a route. So which is the best route is the one which we take up the shortest route. So your optimization technique, when you write a program, let us suppose if you're going to appear for an interview, so 5 students are appearing under a particular head and everyone is asked to write a program on to calculate the factorial of a given number. So when you are about to write, it is not the case that everyone will go with the same approach. Okay. So while you are writing a program, we have to think in a mind that the way we write a program should be in an optimized way. That is, optimized here is the usage of resources should be less. The variables what we use in the program should be minimized. The processor time, how it can be reduced. Is this necessary or not? So those sort of, is it required or not, which is efficient in a way that we utilize the resources in an efficient way. That talks about the optimization. It will have a light mathematical touch with this and you learn the subject. And you could see a web page design when hope everyone might have purchased some products in online. You might have gone for eBay, Amazon, Flipkart. Everyone, they have their own web portals and we go inside their web page and then we look for the product. So Flipkart, when you compare, you can compare your cost and the elegance of attraction. Certain times we feel that though the price is less, the interaction will be good in certain web pages. So that is how they design it. So you will be given a foundation of how to design your web pages, web programming will be taught, PHP will be taught, how to design it, and all those things will be taught at this end. And programming, once being a computer science student, we should know how to do a program. So all the program foundations will be given in order to develop whatever you think. So that is many programming. I have listed only few. It's not the thing I have listed all the subjects. I have listed only very few subjects over here. And then coming with storage, database and analytics. What is the storage? Is I store my data. So now the Department of Computer Science, CT, IT and BCA, they cumulatively store the talk, what I'm going, what it is going on. They store it in their database and they're trying to stream to your end. So storage, whether they are going for storage in their server machines, which is deployed or which has been installed in their institution, or they can go for cloud storage. If I feel that I don't have sufficient space, I can go for the cloud storage. So it's either it is a database or it's a cloud storage. You will learn about all those things. And analytics, when I say about the online purchase, you might have seen that when I purchase a particular product, automatically it shows down. The customer or the users who have bought this product also had interest in buying this product. So what they do is they do analytics on the data, how we browse, what is our interest, and they display the message. So there stands the analytics. And they deploy and maintain projects. So we have developed a project using a software engineering will teach you how to plan and organize and to develop a project, how to maintain that project, whether the project is going for the alpha version or beta version or the final version. So what is that alpha and beta? So alpha is one, a project team will be there. They're developing a project and they'll work among the team members. They'll go with that. And next is about the beta version. They give to certain level of customers and they test whether it is functioning as good or not. And the next level is they take up to the next level and they release the product. So those things will be taught in software project management and in software testing. As I said earlier, when I talk in terms of analog, it passes over you and to your YouTube streaming, it is happening. How it is happening? It's all connecting of devices. I connect my machine to an internet via a wireless portal. So I have my dongle with me in my hand where I'm trying to connect it via a wireless way. So similar way, what it happens here is the networking is happening. So how do the data gets transferred? How the data is divided into packets, how it is going to frame it, how IP address is fixed to that packet, how the source address will be determined, all those things you learn about the concept of called networking. And as I said earlier, it is like wherever you go nowadays, you could see a camera over everywhere. So even in small grocery stores, you have a camera. In your campus, you have a camera. Earlier, when they install a camera, they'll have a statement called under the CCTV surveillance. But now it is not the case. Inga pathal camera irukipan the term yarum podrathe illa. So now it is next stage where we are going with sensors. In our mobile phone has 3 to 4 sensors, minimum 3 to 4 sensors, where a smartphone has those sensors. So this Internet of Things deals with connecting devices, connecting not only the devices, the thing, everything which has certain enabled with the chips, then that can be communicate with each other in order to enable with one another. So I am wearing a smartphone. So what the smartphone is, it has some sensors over it. So this sensors, what it does is, it measures my calories the day, the complete day. It measures my calories. It measures my steps of walking. It measures my whatever I fixed it. I can fix it that I want my steps to be measured. I want my calories burned to be measured. I want all those things, all the data, whatever I require, I can fix it. And I can, at the end of the day, it lists me that these things have happened at it. How it happens? A sensor is attached to the phone where the sensor always sits on my hand, which it gets tracking me. So this is how your Internet of Things happens. And the need of the day is the cyber laws and ethical hacking, which is a part of your syllabi or curriculum. So cyber laws. So nowadays, you could see that many cyber crimes are happening. All theft is happening via online. So nowadays, no robbery is happening. Very rare. It's like going and rob. Rare in Solomon, the poet is there. But are they look equal? The cyber theft has been happening. Many cyber laws are there and doing a morphing. And I have seen students being a good friends of both the boys and girls. They have many clippings of photos together. At one end, at one stage, certain thought mind process, when it goes down, what's negative, some vibrations, they do with some morphing of the same image with someone's body, with someone's image. So these things, when it happens, automatically being a protected environment, we were bought, being an Indian and being staying in Tamil Nadu, we'll be having some sort of preservatives in our family. We have some moral values and we have a boundaries in it. When we see a picture of us with our face or with someone's body with not properly dressed, it makes so sensitive to us, and many people take out a wrong decision. So there, where I feel here, many cyber laws are there, and you can approach many cyber departments are there. Actively, the cyber crime departments are functioning where our data will be very much confidential. And even in Coimbatore, they have a separate division for cyber crime, which is an pakka active functioning is there. Our messages will be very confidential. If someone is threatening over a phone, or if something is happening, if someone is trying to make use of a bank accounts, be cautious. And this cyber laws, when you go through your cyber laws, you'll be aware of what are the crimes that is happening, how we can overcome it. So being a computer science student, get tuned up with those crimes, what is happening, what are the laws that is going on. And hacking is, every technology, when you see, it has its ups and downs. When you see a technology with the hacking is something, you are corrupting a machine. I've seen my students, suddenly they'll make our lab machines to get down. And I wonder, and one specialized person hacking will do that and they'll enjoy for fun. So every technology has its ups and downs. When you take a technology on positive sense, it goes with positive thing. When you take a technology with negative approach, then obviously it goes down. So ethical hacking is part of your syllabi for CT and IT. I've seen through the syllabus. And go for your, learn your hacking, and the market is, many cyber crimes are going on and many anti-hacking, how to recover from those hacking, the need of the day, and go through and learn it. And being new to computer science students, you have certain courses with computer installation and servicing, you can go through it. So this is the overall structure, how it has been divided. It's not that all the subjects have been covered. Few subjects alone has been left out in your curriculum. A theory-based subject, an intelligence-based subject, an application development subject. So these are all the things. I'll share the PPT to your faculty. You can get it from them to know. It's all, I have taken it from the web. You can browse it and get the information too. I'm going to say a story about this balloons. You could see a colorful balloons over here. So whenever story comes, I feel comfortable in saying it Tamil than in English. So since no one is difficult in going with Tamil, I'm starting with my Tamil. So in a team lead, I'll come at the end. I'll tell you, there are so many subjects in all of us. So if I'm interested in programming, I'll learn programming. If I'm interested in developing an IoT component, I'll deploy a component. If I'm interested in software management, I'll manage it. So in the mari namma different idhila inda course vandu ungalku enna na or platform mari kuduthuru. So in the platform la nee enna panna pora appadina, so what you will do is you will learn everything and you will fix it in your mind, this gives me an interest, I can learn more about it, and you can get specialized by going with skill based subjects or specialized online courses you can take up and you can learn more on it. Appa namma vandu company industry ku pora appo enna agudina, they ask what is your specialization and I say I'm good in programming, okay I'll be put it in the programming team. So அப்படி வந்து ஒரு டீம் லீட் வந்து ஒரு இன்டர்வியூ எடுக்கிறாரு. ஸோ இன்டர்வியூல வந்து ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்ட் கேரி அவுட் பண்ணணும் அப்படின்னா ஒரு டெவலப்பர் வேணும், ஒரு ப்ராஜெக்ட் டீம் லீட் வேணும், ஒரு டெஸ்டர் வேணும், ஒரு அனலைஸ் பண்ணி நமக்கு அந்த சாஃப்ட்வேர் இன்ஜினியரிங் அனலிஸ்ட் வேணும், ஒரு சயின்டிஸ்ட் வேணும், அ காம்பினேஷன் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் வில் பி தேர் இன் ஆர்டர் டு கேரி அவுட் த ப்ராஜெக்ட். அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு இன்டர்வியூ நடத்துறாரு. ஹி வாஸ் அட் த எண்ட் ஆஃப் த ஹி வாஸ் சோ ஹாப்பி. ஏன் அப்படின்னா அவர் நினைச்ச மாதிரி ஆளுங்க நினைச்ச மாதிரி அப்படிங்கிறப்ப த கேண்டிடேட்டர்ஸ் not only sound and technical, the attitude matters. When you come into the industry, I've seen few students got rejected though they are good in technical. That is the approach what we take, the body language what we show, everything has to be learned during this course of study. The way you speak to them, the way you approach them, the way you have your eye contact, everything matters there. So avarku vandha at the end of the day happier irukkar. Yen appadina namakku nenacha mari nalla attitude oda நல்ல ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் நல்ல கேண்டிடேட்ஸ் ஐ ஹவ் டேக்கன் அப் ஃபார் மை டீம். மை டீம் இஸ் சோ குட் தட் ஐ கேன் ஃபினிஷ் மை ஒர்க். என்னோட ஒர்க் நான் வந்து ஸ்டிப்புலேட்டட் டைம்ல முடிச்சிடலான்னு ஒரு ஹாப்பியா ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் அந்த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டே. நெக்ஸ்ட் டே மீட்டிங் போடுறாரு, அவங்க அவங்களுக்கு உண்டான டாஸ்க் அசைன் பண்றாரு, அண்ட் தென் ஹி சேஸ் லெட் ஸ்டார்ட் அ ப்ராஜெக்ட். அண்ட் தென் எல்லாரும் வராங்க. ஸோ ஒரு ஒன் வீக் போது அந்த டீம் லீடுக்கு ஒரே ஹாப்பி வந்து பாக்குறாரு, எல்லாரும் சின்சியரா ஒர்க் பண்றாங்க, ஆன் டைம் வந்துடுறாங்க. So everything was going fine and he was so happy. Week went, 2 weeks went, he was so happy. And he was as was his plan, நம்ம நல்ல டீம் வச்சிருக்கோம், நம்ம 2 months செய்ய வேண்டிய ப்ராஜெக்ட் ஒரே மாசத்துல முடிச்சிடலாம், ரொம்ப ரிகரஸா வந்து பார்த்துட்டே இருக்காரு. 3 weeks over, a month over, a month and a half over, and the project doesn't come to end. He was a bit upset and day he was thinking all the while, why this is happening? எல்லாருமே நல்ல developers and the team, but why it is not happening and the thought avarkulliye irukku. Adukapram vandha he analyzed and next day he came to office back and every members has come and they all went to their cabins, to their place to do their work, and he called everyone, today your cabin has been changed. Appadina ellathu surprising why what abringra question oda paakranga. ஸோ அவர் என்ன பண்றாருன்னா எல்லாத்தையும் கூட்டிட்டு போய் இந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ரூம்க்கு கொண்டு போய் விடுறாரு. அந்த ரூம் ஃபுல்லா பலூன்ஸா இருக்கு, எல்லாத்துக்கும் சர்ப்ரைசிங். அந்த டோர் ஓப்பன் பண்ணாலும் இவ்வளவு பலூன்ஸ் எதுக்காக சார் இங்க கூட்டிட்டு வர்றாரு நம்ம டீம் லீட் அப்படின்னு யோசிக்கிறாங்க. அப்ப அவர் சொல்றாரு, இங்க பலூனுக்கு நடுவுல உங்க நேம் பிரிண்ட் ஆன பலூன்ஸ் வந்து இருக்கு. ஸோ ஐ கிவ் யூ ஸ்டிபுலேட்டட் டைம், யூ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு ஹாவ் யுவர் ஓன் பலூன்ஸ் இன் யோர் ஹேண்ட். உங்க நேம் பிரிண்ட் ஆயிருக்க பலூன் உங்க கையில இருக்கணும்னு சொல்லிடுறாரு. So everyone is going in and they are in a stipulated time constraint irukku. Nee industry ku ponaena endha work edutala time constraint irukku. So and the time constraint la ellaru they started balloon searching for balloons. Adhula or condition enna solrana, endha balloon ni burst panna koodadhu appdi. So nama project edukkrappum we'll have lot of conditions and then they went in ulla poi avanga ella paakranga. After a certain period of time the bell rings, the team lead comes and he says your time is up. அப்ப டைம் அப் ஆயிடுச்சு, நோ ஒன் ஹேட் தே பலூன் தே ஹேட். அண்ட் டீம் லீட் செட், ஓகே ஐ வில் கிவ் யூ அனதர் சான்ஸ். அண்ட் வாட் யூ செட் இஸ் நவ் ஐ ஹவ் அப்சர்வ்ட் யூ தட் எவ்ரி ஒன் வாஸ் சர்ச்சிங் ஃபார் யுவர் நேம். நவ் வாட் யூ டூ இஸ் வென் யூ ஃபைண்ட் அ பலூன் வித் சம்மன்ஸ் நேம், ஜஸ்ட் ஹேண்ட் ஓவர் டு தெம் அண்ட் தென் ஸ்டார்ட் சர்ச்சிங் ஃபார் சம் ஒன். ஸோ யூ கேன் ஹாவ் தட் பாலிசி அண்ட் தென் யூ கேன் கீப் சர்ச்சிங். த சேம் டைம் வில் பி கிவன் அண்ட் த சேம் கண்டிஷன், பலூன் சுட் நாட் பி பர்ஸ்டட். அண்ட் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஸ்டார்டட் டூயிங் பட் ஷேரிங் தேர் balloons with some other's name. யாரோட பலூன் தன்னோட நேம் இல்லைனா யாரோட பலூன் அவங்க கையில கொடுத்துட்டு அவங்க வந்து ஸ்டார்டட் சர்ச்சிங். So this was happened within a stipulated time. The team lead came and the bell rings and everyone had their balloon. The team lead could see the such a happiness and cherishment in their face, not only with the team members, with the team lead also. And finally the team lead says that this is what I expected in your work also. Everyone were good in doing it. Everyone was good in searching for balloon. But what it was lacking is your coordination was lacking. So being a school student, where individually focusing on your subject to getting your score, coming into your college, at times you need a team coordination in order to carry out a task, in order to learn something, in order to go for a competition. So that team effort is required. Being an industry techians, when you go into your industry, and the team effort namakku venum. So that is a point what I'm stressing on you here is a team, is a team coordination and team communication is must, and have that practice once you enter into your college. That is a message what I want to convey you through the story. And coming to the technology trend, lot of technology is keeping on increasing. I'm not going to list out all the technologies. One which is my favorite, I come out with an IoT, Internet of Things. So it's a prediction like 75 billion devices in 2025. La number of devices, ethana devices in the connect aayirukku internet connect aayirukku IoT lina 75 billion devices will be connected, and AI market has its own role. And then AR and VR, that is augmented reality and virtual reality. You being the young generation, you'll be aware of the gaming. We're virtual world kula mall kulaila ponave nam ulla poi panna as if we feel that we are driving a vehicle, as if we feel that we are fighting with one another. And the virtual environment ipo vandu teaching environment, teaching kula vandirche. For kindergarten students, they show a demo as if the real elephant is inside the classroom. They teach modalla enna na play card mari card kaamchi idha elephant mbanga adukapra enna aachu first ela varanji kaanpaanga board la. அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்து கார்டு காமிக்க ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க. இப்போ சிஸ்டம்ல நம்ம ப்ரொஜெக்டர்ல டிஸ்பிளே பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கோம். இப்போ அடுத்தது வந்து என்னன்னா, விஆர் அண்ட் ஆர்குமெண்ட் ரியாலிட்டி யூஸ் பண்ணி என்ன பண்றாங்க அப்படின்னா, தே ஷோ த ரியல் எலிஃபண்ட் இஸ் ஆஸ் ஆஃப் இன்சைட் கிளாஸ் ரூம், திஸ் இஸ் அ எலிஃபண்ட், திஸ் இஸ் அ ட்ரங்க். அந்த மாதிரி தான் திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு யுவர் ஏஆர் மார்க்கெட் இஸ் கோயிங் ஆன். அண்ட் ஐடி பில்லர்ஸ்குள்ள வரப்ப என்னதுன்னா, சாஃப்ட்வேர் டெவலப்மெண்ட் 57% ஆஃப் டைம் ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்றாங்க, 51% ஆஃப் சைபர் செக்யூரிட்டி ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்றாங்க. டேட்டா, ஆஸ் ஐ செட், the data is keeping on increasing. முதல்ல ஒரு போட்டோ எடுக்கணும் அப்படின்னா ரோல் இருக்கு, அதுல 32 போட்டோஸ் தான் எடுக்க முடியும். அந்த ரோலை கொண்டு போய் அழுங்காம டச் பண்ணாம ஸ்டுடியோல கொடுத்தா அவன் பிரிண்ட் போட்டு கொடுப்பான். அப்புறம் டிஜிட்டல் கேமரா வந்துச்சு, எடுத்து 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 டிரைவ்ல போட்டு வச்சோம். பென் டிரைவ்ல இருக்கு, அங்க இருக்கு, இங்க இருக்கு, நிறைய டேட்டா ஆயிடுச்சு. இப்ப மொபைல் வந்ததுல இருந்து 1 கேமரா, 2 கேமரா, டுவல் கேமரா, 3 கேமரா, 4 கேமரா போன்ஸோட தான் இருக்கும். பவுனை வாங்கணும்னு எவ்வளவு கேமரான்னு கேட்கறதுல ஒரு கியூரியாசிட்டி, என்ன பிக்சல்ஸ்ன்னு கேட்கறதுல ஒரு கியூரியாசிட்டி வந்துருச்சு. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவு த டேட்டா கீப்ஸ் இன்க்ரீசிங். ஸோ வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன் வென் கீப்பிங் ஆன் இன்க்ரீசிங் வித் திஸ், வென் யூ டேக் அ போட்டோ, ஒரு நாளைக்கு ஹவு மெனி செல்ஃபிஸ் யூ டேக், வென் யூ ஸ்மைல் அட் ஒன் அண்ட் யூ டேக் அ செல்ஃபி, வென் யூ டேர்ன் பேக் யூ டேக் அ செல்ஃபி. ஸோ இட் கீப்ஸ் ஆன் இன்க்ரீசிங். அண்ட் யூ ஸ்டோர் யர் டேட்டா சம்வேர், வென் யூர் மொபைல் டசன்ஸ் ஆஃப் இட், யூ ஸ்டோர் இட் இன் யுவர் மெயில் டிரைவ். ஸோ சர்டன் அனாலிட்டிக்ஸ் இன் டர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் பிஸ்னஸ் ஹஸ் டு பி டன். So the 47% they are focusing on data, and 45 is infrastructure. So the infrastructure is not a single time, it's like cloud, what I said, networking, storage, server, IoT, mobile device, Linux, and the front end support softwares, everything comes inside the infrastructure. So these are all considered to be the organizational focus. இது மட்டும் தானா அப்படினா, it's not case. Apart from it, many focus are there. This is the major focus. The majority, it goes beyond 50%. And the, coming to method of learning, school education, again, I repeated, you will have a small book. Once you complete that book, that is over. For physics in the book, for science in the book, for computer science in the book, you will have a guide. Sometimes you may have a guide, and the guide like a question, padicha mudichida. But when you come for your collegiate education, I have seen students were struggling a lot when you try to mug up something, that is mug up panni memorize pannano sila da memorize panna mudiyum ellathiyum memorize panna mudiyadhu when you come for your college education. So you should understand something, whatever concept, try to understand, think how it is possible, how can we expel it. You think in all those aspects and do it, don't memorize. Once you memorize, I've seen students write from program line number 1 to 40, they'll keep memorizing. Before the exam, before entering inside the lab, they'll have their record notes, they'll keep memorizing. Once they close and 2 questions is asked in between, they'll forget about the in-between lines. Our total whole program will be out of their memory. So this is how the situations will happen, where you'll keep your head, hands on your head and say, I'm blank. So when you understand the logic and when you understand the syntax should be memorized, no other go. Syntax of your programming language should be memorized. The concepts can be understood in theory subjects. Don't memorize. I insert the second point here is, don't memorize. Understand something and learn. And I'm going to end up the session. and with a small story again. The story is about a eagle and a crow. Kaluga kaagam pathina story. So kaluga vandu disturb pandra ore parava enna appadina kaagam da enna pannu appadina kaluga vandu melayena mostly parandite da irukku எப்ப அதுக்கு தனக்கு இறை கிடைக்குது அப்படிங்கிறப்ப அது அப்படியே கீழே பறந்து அது பாத்தீங்கன்னா அதனோட வந்து வந்து எடுத்துட்டு இட் கீப்ஸ் ஃப்ளைங் அந்த கேப்ல அது பறக்கிறப்ப என்ன பண்ணுவா காகம் போய் அது மேல உட்காந்துக்கும் சோ யூ குட் சீ ஃப்ரம் தி பிக்சர் காகம் போய் மேல உட்காந்துக்கும் காகம் மேல மட்டும் உட்காராது அது கம்மன் அது என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா கொஞ்ச நேரம் உட்காந்துருக்கும் அதுக்கப்புறம் அது ஒண்ணு கொத்த ஆரம்பிக்கும் காகம் வந்து கழுகு வந்து இது பண்ணும் கழுகு வந்து காகம் வந்து தம் மேல உட்கார்ந்தது பத்தியும் கவலைப்படாது இது பண்ணிட்டு இருக்கிறத பத்தி கவலைப்படாது அது தனக்கு என்ன டார்கெட்டோ அதை ஃபோக்கஸ் பண்ணி போயிட்டே இருக்கும் கொஞ்சம் பீரியட் ஆஃப் டைம் அது வந்து கொத்த ஆரம்பிக்கிறதுக்காக கழுகுக்கு ஒரு லெவல் ஆஃப் பேஷன்ஸ் லெவல் வில் பி முடிஞ்சிடும் பேஷன்ஸ் லெவல்னா தன்னோட சகிப்புத்தன்மை ஒரு லிமிட்டுக்கு தான் இருக்கும் அதுக்காக வந்து அது சண்டை போடாது அது புத்திசாலித்தனமா என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா கழுகு இன்னும் உயர பறக்க ஆரம்பிச்சு இட் கீப்ஸ் ஃப்ளைங் ஹை ஸோ வென் இட் கோஸ் பியாண்ட் சர்டன் லெவல் காகத்துக்கு வந்து ஆக்சிஜன் லெவல் பத்தாது சுவாசிக்க முடியாது ஸோ கழுக அது கழுகுனால போற ஹை ஹை ஹையா இருக்கிற வரைக்கும் வந்து காகத்தினால மேல பறக்க முடியாது அதனால என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா காகம் வந்து ஒரு ஸ்டேஜுக்கு மேல கீழே விழுந்துடும் கீழே விழுந்தோன்னு என்ன ஆகும் அப்படின்னா கழுகு தன்னோட இலக்கை நோக்கி பறந்துட்டே இருக்கு ஸோ எப்பெல்லாம் இறை இருக்கோ வந்து எடுத்துட்டு இட் கீப்ஸ் ஃப்ளைங் அப் ஸோ காகம் இடையில வந்தாலும் காகம் வெளியே அது வந்து தன்னை டிஸ்டர்ப் பண்ணாலும் அது பாட்டுக்கு போறப்ப என்ன ஆகுதுன்னா காகம் ஒரு ஸ்டேஜுக்கு மேல அதனோட கோப்ப பண்ண முடியாம இட் கீப்ஸ் டிராப்பிங் ஸோ அது தன்னோட கீழே விழுங்க ஆரம்பிச்சிடும் ஏன்னா அதனால சுவாசிக்க முடியாது அந்த ஹைட்டுக்கு அதனால போனா ஆக்சிஜன் லெவல் பத்தாது ஸோ தட் இஸ் லைக் நீ வந்து கழுகா இருக்க போறிய நீ காலேஜ் எஜுகேஷன்ல வந்து நீ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் பிளாட்ஃபார்ம்ஸ்ல இருந்து வந்திருப்ப யூ மைட் பி கம்மிங் ஃப்ரம் ஐ ஸ்ட்ரீம் யூ மைட் பி ஃப்ரம் சிபிஎஸ்சி யூ மே பி ஃப்ரம் மெட்ரிகுலேஷன் யூ மே பி ஃப்ரம் காமன் ஸ்கூல் வாட் எவர் இட் மே பி த பிளாட்ஃபார்ம் கொங்கு இஸ் For everyone is the same. It's not, it will not show a difference between any cadre. So, namma valanda environment veetla vera maari irukla. Eppadi irundhalum parvaala. Sutti namla sutti nariya kaagangalum irupaanga. Namla sutti nariya kalugum irupaanga. Nee kaagama irukka poriya illa kaluga irukka poriya ngattu choices left to you. So, ennoda wishes vandu nee kaluga iru unnoda ilakkai nokki po. You might have a target. Namma mudichittu ipdi irukkonu. Namakku family commitments irukku. Na inda admi na enakku idhu dhaan enoda pressure. இது அச்சீவ் பண்ணணும் யூ மைட் ஹாவ் சர்டன் ட்ரீம்ஸ் இன் யுவர் லைஃப் அச்சீவ் யுவர் ட்ரீம்ஸ் பி அன் ஈகிள் அச்சீவ் யுவர் டார்கெட் அண்ட் கீப் கோயிங் டோன்ட் பாதர் ஃபார் ஆல் த க்ரோஸ் விச் இஸ் பிஹைண்ட் யூ ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் கீப்பிங் பாதரிங் அபவுட் தெம் தென் யுவர் டார்கெட் வில் நாட் பி அச்சீவ் அண்ட் ஐ விஷ் யூ ஆல் த பெஸ்ட் அண்ட் சேயிங் அபவுட் தேங்க்யூ நோட் ஸோ தேங்க்யூ நோட் சொல்லணும் அப்படின்னா it's like I remember everyone enakku eppume edho oru session vandu I get it from kongu people and they call me for every occasion they remember me and call me I'll get a call from them and I'll say institution la oru naal ungala titta poranga eppa paathala enniye kooptirukinga I always say whenever people call me and they say that okay we I wish and I'm happy to be part of kongu so eppume na kongu la edho oru session commit aagrappo I'll have a pleasant memories right from my career started there in 2003 and enoda pg mudichonae na kongula da join panna faculty angirundha na vandu ovvoru pleasant memories and evergreen memories where I've started my career where I've learned many things there so initially when I was joining it was like Dr. Swaminathan sir was the principal who guided me in between he left for his career growth and ma nariya petha nama vandu விஷ் பண்ணும் தேங்க் பண்ணும்னு ஒவ்வொரு டைமும் நினைச்சிட்டே இருப்பேன் அப்படி நான் இந்த டைம் கொங்குல கமிட் ஆகுறப்போ என்னோட எவர்கிரீன் மெமரிஸ் கூட எனக்குள்ள ஒரு ஹார்ட் ஃபெல்ட் மெமரி ஒன்று அப்படின்னா இட்ஸ் லைக் ஐ விஷ் டு டெடிகேட் திஸ் ஃபார் மை மேம் ரைட் ஃப்ரம் 1997 வென் ஐ ஸ்டார்டட் மை யூஜி ஷீ இஸ் நோன் டு மீ அண்ட் ஷீ இஸ் மை மென்டார் அண்ட் ஷீ இஸ் மை டீச்சர் And later, when I joined in Kongu, she was a colleague. And later, she became my best friend, my family friend, my neighbor. And everything, we share everything. And why I came out this message stating about this, ma'am, yeah, and ma'am out of picture, inga eduthu parnungrappa Kongu nenikrappo, idhu da first time na ma'am illama andha session kula varadhu. Adhu konja romba kashtama irundhudhu. And then, okay, days pass on, everything we have to accept, that is life. Life la edhu vandhal nam accept panni poite irukkunungiradha namakku life oda lessons. Oru part appadi, innoru part enna appadina, the dedication, she is like a legend. Pillar of Kongu kuda sollalam appadi or dedicated faculty ellathiyum thanganga solluvanga faculty athana petti colleagues mostly na paathirukanga thanganga solluvanga. So she'll have lot of web students who she guide them, who become the teacher there. Everyone will go and get advice from her. They're such a dedicated, not only at her career path, also in the family, such a one. Why this message, why I'm saying about these things, I felt that we all missed her few months back. Few months back, she left us. Why, Abdina? Because of health factor. Enna health factor na? Ignorance of health. Idhu dhaan nama ellarum pandra vishayam. Right from the students, I'm pointing you also. You may not be aware of this, ma'am, but sure you'll be missing this, ma'am. Ninga department vandirna if your ma'am illaingiradhu ungalukku unga seniors keta theriyum. Appadi ma'am vandu avlo dedicated ma'am, family liye appadi dedicated ah irupanga, avangaloda career liye appadi dedicated ah irupanga. Ana enna miss pannitaanga appadina avanga health pathi bother panna mudanga, suddenly collapse aitaanga. And collapse ah irukku reason vandu pathinga ignorance of health. What we are all doing now, right from my fellow colleagues, friends, whoever is looking into this, I'm stressing on this point that take care of your health. It is sure that we never fail from our duties. Institution orthung illina arthungla replace panikuvaanga. Being a friend, when we miss her, we cried for her throughout a week, a month together. We felt even now whenever things comes in, she comes into mind. On and off, I take up the video of her and look into it. That's all. Our part is over. And days goes on. And whenever I think about her son, it's so painful thing. Daily he'll be missing her. So nama family members vandu enga vera edathila or friend edathila inor friend replace pannikala irundhal inga edatha fill panna mudiyadunal, we keep moving with our family matters. Institutions la we go with the next events happening odite da irukku. And a family la loss ingiradhu loss na. So what I insist here is technology grow aite irukku. So throughout the day, we sit before the machines. Nowadays, we sit before machines. And you, the children, you always sit before machines for your online class. Apart from it, you have a gaming time. Nariya pethukran, right from school children, 1 hour gaming time, 2 hour gaming time, PUBG valayaravangala, continuous timings. Namari or limited lama gaming time poodha. Apart from it, chat, mobile, social media, other than WhatsApp chat la nariya time spend pandro. ஸோ நம்மளோட நெக் அண்ட் ஐ ஸ்ட்ரெயின் எவ்வளோங்கிறது நமக்கு இப்போ புரிய மாட்டேங்குது. நம்ம பாடியை ஒரு நம்ம பாடியும் ஒரு மெஷின் தான். அது ஓரளவுக்கு தான் நம்ம கோப்பப் பண்ணும். சம்டைம்ஸ் இட் ட்ரிகர்ஸ் பி ஷோயிங் அண்ட் சிம்டம்ஸ் லைக் வாட் இட் ஹாஸ் பீன் ஷோன் டு மேம், பட் மேம் இக்னோர் பண்ணிட்டாங்க. ஸோ நம்ம எல்லாரும் அவேராக இருப்போம். அட் த சேம் டைம் வாட் ஐ இன்சிஸ்ட், ஸ்பெண்ட் சம் டைம் ஃபார் அவர் சில்ட்ரன். Though we have, it's not that we are not to deny our duties, we are taking up duty. And when I committed for the session 2 days back, I said to my son, 2 days mattum unai gavanik mudiyadha, amma tension pannada, nee vandu carry on with your work, after 2 days I'll be back to you. So just pacify them, say them we are there for you. At the same time, we are in 40s and 50s, we have been working together throughout with lot of hectic schedule. Take care of your children, take care of your health, and wish you all the best. Students, mainly the food habits what you are having right now, naanga chinna vayasula saapta nalla healthy saapadu modi pilla full of fertilizers. So have a healthy food as far as possible and take care of your health. Move away from your gadgets for some time, move away from your screen, have some physical activity. For everyone I'm saying, right from the, in our 40s 50s and physical activity vanda, and I'm 20s, I'm healthy, physical activity. If at any age you need certain physical activities. And we don't want to miss any of our friend anymore because of ignorance of health. And thank you all for giving me this opportunity. And hope something has given to you at my end. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am, for your technologically informative, inspirational, life-motivating, and encouraging speech. We hope that certainly your thoughts and words will ignite our younger minds and lead them to venture into their successful academic life. Thank you, ma'am. Now it's time for question and answer session. Dear students, if you have any questions or doubts to be solved, you can post your queries in the chat box. Students, if you have any questions or doubts to be solved, you can post your queries in the chat box.
I think they'll not have questions once they get inside the college, and they'll have certain doubts about it. Being in online mode, saying about curriculum, I don't know how far it has reached them.
Dear students, the feedback link has been shared in the chat box. Please fill it before leaving the session. As all things come to an end, we hardly realize that we receive a great deal more than what we give, and that it is only with gratitude that the life becomes rich. Now I call upon Dr. P. Kallarani, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Technology and Information Technology, to propose the vote of thanks.
Good morning to all. I have the pleasant task of proposing the vote of thanks to all on behalf of the Department of Computer Science UG, Department of Computer Technology and Information Technology, and the Department of Computer Applications. First of all, I would like to express my profound gratitude to our resource person, Dr. P.P. Pangachavalli Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, School of Computer Science and Engineering, Barbier University, Coimbatore, for her valuable and wonderful presentation. Thank you, ma'am. It's my privilege to thank has been a guiding pillar for us in all our days. Thank you, sir. I extend my sincere gratitude to our principal, Dr. N. Raman, sir, for his genuine guidance and thoughtful ideas. Thank you, sir. We are much grateful to Mr. P. Ramesh, sir, head of the Department of Computer Science UG, Mr. S. Burhanandam, sir, head of the Department of Computer Technology and Information Technology, and Dr. T. A. Sangeeta, ma'am, head of the Department of Computer Applications, for their inspiring encouragement and constant support for the successful completion of the program. I take this opportunity to thank our beloved faculty members of Computer Science UG, Computer Technology and Information Technology, and Computer Applications for the timely help and assistance. I feel happy to thank our students for their active participation and kind cooperation. Once again, I thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I take this wonderful moment to thank all the students who gave their active participation in the student induction program. And I thank all who worked sincerely to make this program a grand success. Thank you all.
Thank you. Can I leave?
Yes, ma'am. We will wind up. Thank you so much for your wonderful lesson. We will leave.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.